Hello guys, welcome to Hankins Custom Rifles and another episode of Hank's TV. And today what we're going to talk about is a little breech plug that I've started making. It's a conversion for a lot of different guns out there. I really don't even know how to start this video other than just getting into it and telling you guys what I've got, what's available, what we can do and can't do. Phil Justless, a lot of you guys know who he is. A lot of you don't, but he came up with this design years ago, and it's basically a breech plug with no bushing in it at all. It's got a hole, goes all the way through, and there's no carbide bushing, no tungsten bushing in there whatsoever. So that's one part you don't ever have to worry about wearing out. It's never going to wear out because it's not in there. And his ignition source to hold the primer was a little screw. So these little screws will screw into these breech plugs with a primer in it. And you can shoot your gun. You deprime it by unscrewing this little screw. Now the negatives to this, the drawback is you have to unscrew it. It takes a little while to unscrew that thing all the way out there. It's a 5/16 24 thread. So you got to turn the bolt 12 times to get it out. It's a half inch long. The advantages to it is it's a better ignition. Cold weather, it would be a great ignition to take if you were going out on a really cold weather hunt. We are hunting with muzzle loaders, fellas, so one shot should be all you need. That should be all you count on. You shouldn't have to worry about how fast can you reload, because in reality, you shouldn't be reloading at all. If you have to reload, you did something wrong, and you can't blame nobody but yourself on that. You took a bad shot if you're sitting there trying to reload and you got deer flopping around down there. So, but anyway, we won't go there. Everybody's ethics are different. Take a shot if you think you can make it. Now, we got a gun that we're going to shoot a little bit today. We'll go over that here in a minute, but I want to just explain a little bit about this breech plug and the system and how it works, because I put some information out on the message board, and I'm already getting bombarded with people wanting these things or wanting to ask me how it works and all that kind of stuff. So we're going to go over that a little bit. Okay guys, so we're down here and we're looking at all these breech plugs that I've got. I made several different breech plugs for a lot of different guns. I thought I had everything covered, and sure enough, the first day or two I put it out there, somebody's asking about a breech plug that I don't have. Now I can make it, that's no big deal, but I have to be able to make several of them to make it worth my while. And that's a Savage, original Savage plug that was used in the old muzzle loaders. I'm not going to recommend this system to be used in a muzzle loader without locking lugs, because you have nothing holding back the primer and the pressure except that little bolt that cams the action down, cams the bolt closed. So I'm not going to say you can use it in there. I would not use this in nothing but a gun that has locking lugs or a break action. So let's talk about this just for a second here. We've got these bolts. These are grade 9 aircraft bolts. They were pretty expensive. I had to buy a lot of them to get what I wanted. I had these made because I wanted them to be a half inch long. You can buy them off the shelf, but they're 3/4 inch long, and that's just way more than you need. It's another 1/4 inch of metal you got to drill a hole through. A drill bit will only drill about 100 of these if you're lucky, and you got to put a new drill bit in because these things are so hard. This is grade 9 steel. The primer pocket's bored with a single point carbide boring bar. And they, even the boring bars don't last very long, so these are kind of expensive to make, very time consuming. Had a few people ask, well, how do you put primers in them? Well, if you've got a reloading press, most everybody out there does, you can buy this little shell holder. And I make these, and this shell holder will hold your primer module. So you put the shell holder in your reloading press, just like if you was going to reload a .30-06 cartridge or a .308 or whatever you want. You put it right in there. It goes in. They fit my rams on my Hornady presses. If you've got an RCBS press or a Redding or somebody else's press, you may have to modify this just a little bit to get it to go in there. 99% chance I would think you won't have to, but worst comes worst, a little file or sandpaper and you can make it fit. So then you've got your priming arm that goes in your reloading press. Every reloader that I've ever seen will come with one of these priming arms. So you put your priming arm in there and you take your primer and you set it in the priming arm, just like you would if you were going to prime a rifle cartridge. And now you slide your ignition module into basically the shell holder and you just push it in. So now we have a live primer in the module, and I got two of these out to do two of them for you. I think that's good enough for a demonstration. Slide that in there and lock it down. Now we've got two with primers in them. I've got a half a dozen or so back here that I've already primed up, and I don't have any that's fired. So to deprime them, you can do it a couple of different ways. If you already have bought one of these shell holders, you could put the primer module in the shell holder and take a hammer and a punch and knock it out. And I'm not going to knock this one out because it's a live primer. Or I make another little kit that you can buy, and it's a shell holder, module holder, decapping stand I usually call it, and that bolt will fit right in that decapping stand. You can take a little hammer and a punch and knock that out. Now if you buy this decapping stand from me, I sell it with a hammer and it comes with a sterret punch. I've been selling these for a long time. Most people that buy a muzzleloader from me will buy this little hammer, this little decapping stand. It's really nice. It's handy to have when you're out at the bench. You don't have to have a reloader to knock your primers out. You will have to have a reloader to put them back in, because we don't have a shell holder yet made for the handheld priming tools. This little hammer is a pretty nice little hammer. It's made out of stainless steel and brass. It'll fit in your reloader box, fit in your possibles bag. It's a lot better than having a big 16-ounce claw hammer in your reloader box. And then this punch, it's a sterret. That's the top of the line sterret punches that I sell if you buy this little decapping stand and hammer kit. So let's see, what else can I tell you here? We're going to shoot this gun a couple of times. And this particular gun here has this plug in it. I made this plug for a fella that sent me a barrel probably a year ago, year and a half, it's been a while. And he sent me this breech plug, or the gun I should say. And he wanted me to convert this gun over to use smokeless powder. Well, we couldn't really do it with the plug that I normally would use in an Apex, because this was a muzzleloader barrel. It has no extractor in it. So when you open it, there's no way really to get the primer out other than using that tool to pop out the 209s. He didn't want to go 209s. He wanted to go large rifle magnum primers, and we're going to shoot smokeless powder out of this gun. Now, you might ask, why do I have black tape holding the forearm on? This forearm and this receiver is my gun. That's off of my 4570 Apex. The centerfire builds that CVA makes has two holes to hold the forearm on. The CVA muzzleloader barrel only has one hole to hold the forearm on, and it's right in the middle. The customer only sent me the barrel. He didn't send me a receiver. He didn't send me a forearm. So I just black taped this on here for my comfort today while I test fire this. And once we do the test fire, I'll take the tape off, take the barrel back off. The barrel gets sent to him, and I keep all the rest of this stuff, and I'll be able to put my 4570 or my Apex conversion, I'll be able to put it back together. So We're going to start out, we'll just go ahead and load this gun up. And I've got 50 grains. That's what we're going to shoot out of this. This is a woods gun. We don't need to shoot big maximum load, so we're shooting 50 grains of IMR 4198. We're going to shoot a 275 grain Parker BE bullet. Okay, and I'm going to use this ramrod for pushing it down. Push it all the way down on the powder charge. This ramrod I just put in here for looks, just to, so you can see what your gun will look like when it's finished. This ramrod is too short for this particular gun, but like I said, all he sent me was a barrel. So I'm going to set this up on the bench, and we're going to put on the magneto speed, and we'll be ready to test fire it. Okay guys, one thing I forgot to tell you that's pretty important is I loaded this gun on a spent primer, one that had already been fired through the gun. So now that the gun is loaded, it's time to put in a live primer. So you can just open your rifle up, hold it down towards the ground. We'll take this little nut driver that's got a 5/16 12 point socket on it, and I put a magnet inside the socket. So you can get on your little bolt here and unscrew it. And the magnet will hold that bolt in there good enough to get it over and drop it into your box or whatever you've got. And then we're going to put in a live primer. So we've got us a live primer in here, and we're now ready to shoot the gun. Now I was going to do some velocity readings on these, but the battery on my magneto speed is dead and I can't get it to work. So we're not going to get any velocities today, but we will shoot this gun a time or two so I can show you how it works. So we're going to walk down here and fire one off. Okay, that looked to work pretty good to me. Okay, so that worked. What you do now is you can either, if you're done with your gun, you can unload it, or if you want to reload it, you just put you another powder charge in here. Now the advantage of shooting this smokeless powder, it's not in this particular case for this gun, it's not to get those massive amounts of speeds and all this power so you can kill a deer at 400 or 500 yards. This is a woods hunting gun. 50 grains of powder is more than you'll ever need. You can shoot these little thin skin bullets. You'll get good obstetrician out of it. You can shoot a 45 caliber sabo with a 40 caliber bullet in it. Knocks the recoil way down for you. And now what we're ready to do is put in a new primer. You'll do that just like I showed you the first time. Put a live one in there. And really on these break actions, it doesn't take that much longer to load it. It's a little bit longer on a bolt action because you have to pull the bolt out and you've got to go up through the action with a longer extension. But it works the same way. Phil Justice did it down here at the Kentucky Challenge. He didn't have any problem with doing it. And his guns shot really, really good. So, fellas, you can just keep doing that over and over. Load the gun, shoot it. I think what we'll do is load it and we'll shoot it one more time. And then I'll show you how to decap your primers. This thing's got pretty good little bit of recoil with 50 grains of powder. But you are getting direct ignition, full power, from your primer module. I'm shooting large rifle magnum primers, but realistically you could get by with large rifle primers. You don't need the magnums in this gun. Pull that module out, put another one in. Okay, and you guys saw how long that took to load this gun back up. Not that long. So, it's definitely faster than if you had a 209 primer stuck in it and you're out there trying to pry it out with a tool. You still have to carry a tool with you. So fellas, that's the way the new direct ignition system works. That's about all I'm going to shoot. What we can do now is, let's see, where's them fired primers at? Here we go. We'll knock these primers out. I'll show you how that is. And I mean, that's pretty much, that'll be the end of the video here. Okay guys, I just got word we needed to do a battery change on the camera, so I don't know exactly where I was at. But we shot the gun. We're up here now to where we're going to knock these primers out. You take one of these spent modules, you set it in the decapping stand, you take a little punch and knock it out of there. Pretty easy, just like that. That primer's out. Now you can put a new one in, or if you don't have the decapping stand and you do have the shell holder, you can put a primer in the shell holder and do it pretty much the same way. It's a little more cumbersome because the thing will slide around on you in the shell holder, and you want to make sure that you're centered over this hole so that you can push the primer through that hole. And if it was me, I would probably just buy one of these shell holders. This is made out of stainless steel. It's not going to beat up, dent, mar. This is made out of aluminum, so if you did a lot of beating on it, you could deform it a little bit over time. So that's where we're at here. Let's see, while we got you on the camera, let me show you the rest of these breech plugs we've got. A lot of you are familiar with these plugs, a lot of you are not, but this plug right here is my original Hankins ignition system plug. If you have one of my guns, you should be able to buy this plug kit from me. Take your plug out, screw this plug in, and screw these modules into this plug. And your gun should function. Bolts should close, everything should work. All right. Now, the second plug we've got here, this is an Arrowhead Sporting Goods plug. This is a 9/16 plug, 1.5 inches long. And if you've got a gun out there built on an Arrowhead Sporting Goods plug sporting a 209 primer, you should be able to remove it, install this plug into your gun, screw in one of these primer modules, and your 209 primer gun is now a large rifle magnum ignition gun with a direct flame path. No restrictions whatsoever. Like I said, I only recommend this on guns with locking lugs or break action. Let's see, we'll go to this plug next. This is my little break action plug. This is the plug that would be in all the break actions that I have built. It's a 9/16 by 24 thread. It's 1 inch long. You can screw this plug into your gun, remove your original plug, screw in these little primer modules and your little break action Encore, Apex, H&R, whatever it is that I've converted for you, should work. And then last but not least, this plug here was designed to fix a lot of Encores out there. This is an Encore thread. It's 11/16 20. But I made this plug a little longer than the factory Encore plugs because a lot of guys have got barrel erosion right here in this area on their barrel. And the only way to fix that is to go back in the barrel and resurface it. Put a new plug in. And this plug here will fix a lot of those problems. So it's about 100 thousandths longer than the factory setup. And basically install it, set your headspace with the module in place, and you're good to go. So we've got five different plugs here. This one is the same plug that's in this gun. It's an Apex muzzleloader barrel plug. It's that quick speed breech plug or whatever they called it. From shooting this rifle, it looks like it's going to work pretty well. I know the Encores work really well. I know all of these is going to work pretty good because Phil Justice has been shooting them for a couple years. And if it wasn't for Phil doing this, he's the man really behind all this. He designed it, came up with the ideas. He's the guy that came up with the idea of this little shell holder. He's pretty sharp tack, and he gave me the permission to copy all this stuff and make it available to the public. I manufacture all these parts on CNC equipment, and the tolerances are pretty tight. Most of the time, everything will be just a swap out, in and out. And I said, when I did tell you about these plugs, I said it should work. And 99% of the time it probably will work, but that's going to depend on who put the plug in, how much headspace they gave you, and a few other things. You know, if you've got a barrel nut on the gun and your bolt don't close, you can always loosen the nut, tighten the barrel up a little bit. If it closes too loose, you can loosen the nut, tighten the barrel up a little bit. Either way you go. But if you've got a Remington gun with a shoulder on it and it doesn't close, you're going to have to go in there and cut that shoulder down some. Or you could shave a little bit off the plug. There's a couple different ways of fixing it, but let's hope we don't run into those problems. I'm sure we will. I've had that problem in the past, but it's not very common. But anyway, fellas, this is what we got. This is the new direct ignition is what it's being called. Phil Justice gave it that name. We're going to stick with it. It sounds like a good name for it. It's a direct ignition breech plug. Would work great for you guys that hunt in a really, really cold climate. There will be no more misfires for you guys in the cold weather. That's going to conclude this video, fellas. I hope this explained a lot of the questions that you've had. I do have them available. They're made. I got them on the shelf. They're bagged up and ready to go. Here's what you're going to get if you buy a breech plug kit. You're going to get one plug. You're going to get 10 modules. That's how it's going to come. Plug with 10 modules. And if you want one, call me or send me an email, and I'll let you know the prices, and I'll get you started and get you a kit on the way. That's going to conclude the video. I'm going to pack everything up and get ready to head to the house. I want to thank you for watching the video. Join the Hank's message board. That's where all this information can be found. It's on there. A lot of guys are talking about it. And if you want one, let me know. Till next time, guys. Thumbs up. We'll see you later.